It was inevitable, Baloo. The boy couldn't help himself. It was bound to happen. Mowgli is where he belongs now.
Yeah. I guess you're right. But I still think he'd have made one swell bear. Well, come on, Baggy Buddy. Let's get back to where we belong and get with the beat. Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities.
Forget about your worries and your strife.
I mean the bare necessities, all Mother Nature's recipes that bring the bare necessities of life.
Take a look at the men who wrote the music for The Jungle Book and Mary Poppins when the Disney Family Album looks at the Sherman Brothers. After that, it's Judy Garland and the lavish musical Meet Me in St. Louis. Then it's Ragtime Adventure with Haley Mills and Burl Ives in Summer Magic. Tonight on the Disney Channel. They took the world by storm and became the legends of their time.
Wake up, wake up, bye-bye, love. Don't want...
The Disney Channel takes you back to the golden age of rock and roll with the Everly Brothers' Rock and Roll Odyssey. Then, after 10 years, together they return to the stage. It's the Everly Brothers' reunion concert on the Sunday Night Showcase. Set Monday nights aside for the greatest entertainment on the Disney Channel's Best of Hollywood.
Hoopsie doody, madam. Grandma Dog did.
This month, it's classic drama, plus a film salute to some of the silver screen's treasured movie musicals.
Everything today is thoroughly modern.
Step out for a smashing good time with Julie Andrews and Mary Tyler Moore in Thoroughly Modern Millie. It's toe-tapping music on the Grand Mississippi.
Old Man River.
Ava Gardner and Howard Keel star in Showboat. Capture the glamour and excitement of a Broadway revue. The star-studded Ziegfeld Follies.
You're no good, neither am I. I don't deserve each other.
A dark tale of deception. Kirk Douglas and Robert Mitchum. Out of the past. It's great entertainment, Monday nights on the Best of Hollywood. The Disney Channel profiles Jerry Lewis.
The expression, born in the trunk, you're born backstage. You're in the wings of a theater. In the case of my dad, he was playing burlesque at the time. And I spent my 2, 3, and 4 week old birthdays backstage at the Palace Theater in Newark. Then at 5, my dad had my first tux made, and I was on stage with him. My mother was a brilliant, brilliant musician, and my mom and dad were my teachers. She with music, my dad with everything else that I do. The spine of my being was built in those conditions. You're born on a trunk. When I wasn't performing with my mother and dad, I was a bus boy.
Hello, I'm Jerry Lewis, the new bus boy.
I'm Dean Martin, the old waiter.
I made my bones in the Bourse circuit. What I learned from the teams that aided Dean and I didn't know I was calling on Laurel and Hardy, who were the premier team for reactions. I mean, it was constant animation. It was beautiful talk and mime. Abbott and Costello was strictly, hey, bud, yeah, Lou, did you know? I didn't. Did you? Aha. But
I'm a real comedian. I got two straight men.
Those two teams were very, very prominent without our knowledge in the learning process. My dad took me to see Jolson on a Sunday night at the Winter Garden Theater. I was in shock at what that man did to that audience. I had to see everybody twice. I would watch first to enjoy them, then I would watch to see what they did to get it done. That was my education. I relived the time. You know, it was a wonderful period for us. We were both 40 years younger. That made me 25 and Dean 35, and we were at the height of young abandonment. To watch these two guys who were so crazy in love with one another and in love with one another's ability, it's magic. It's absolute magic.
Don't you know how to pick up a girl? Sure. I'm over here.
And it's all there in those specials. It was important for me to get behind the camera because I had written a script and all I was getting was directors who were available, not who the best comedy directors were. And I said, before I'm going to take any of these fellas, I'm going to do it myself.
That makes five Jerry Lewises in front of the camera, one behind it, and one somewhere up there running the whole show.
Doing more than one chore is not that difficult if you want to protect that one thing. If you want to protect that one thing, then you can do the other chores that totally protect it. Looking back at my career, and what gave me the most satisfaction would have to be the best shows that I did, being the first entertainer to get a Nobel Peace Prize nomination, getting the French Medal of Honor, Legion of Honor. The two most outstanding things I would say in my career was opening night at the Palace in New York and opening night at the Palladium in London. Those are the two theaters my father said I should play if I was going to be a pro. And I played them, and they were everything he said. I don't have any regrets, not really. I wouldn't change anything. If I did it all over, I think I would do it the same way. The one time around, if you do it right, once is enough, and you don't really need any more than that.
You'll find this living legend on the Disney Channel in our exclusive three-part retrospective, Martin and Lewis, Their Golden Age of Comedy. In the 19th century, American women rose to prominence as major writers. In the vanguard of this movement stood Louisa May Alcott, who in 1868 wrote the internationally acclaimed novel, Little Women. Modeled on Alcott's own experiences, this is the story of four sisters who come of age during the Civil War. In 1933, George Cukor adapted Alcott's novel for the screen, starring Katharine Hepburn. Next week, The American Legacy presents Little Women. Summer, the Disney Channel is turning up the heat with the biggest stars in your favorite movies.
Charming, isn't it?
We've got Newman, Turner, Tandy, Redford, Douglas, McLean, and more in a movie celebration that has romance, comedy, and adventure that's sure to send your pulse sky high.
My minimum price for taking a stranded woman to a telephone is $400.
Will you take $375 in traveler's checks?
American Express?
Of course.
Fair deal.
Kathleen Turner and Michael Douglas give Danny DeVito a run for his money.
I am not pausing.
Get ready for a cliffhanging adventure in Romancing the Stone.
Gonna be some vacation, huh, kids?
And Chevy Chase is heading overseas.
This isn't Wally World, it's a country.
On a whirlwind European tour.
We're the ambassadors of America here.
National Lampoon's European Vacation.
Think you used enough dynamite there, Butch?
Paul Newman, Robert Redford, and Catherine Ross are just working for a living.
I've been working like a dog all my life, and I can't get a penny ahead.
Winner of two Academy Awards, Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid.
I said that there was going to be trouble, but you didn't listen to me.
Then comes a roller coaster ride of thrills, chills, and spills.
Goonies never say die.
Goonies.
The president told the American people that the Soviet Union was building offensive missile and bomber bases in Cuba.
At a time when people were looking for miracles.
The world is going crazy.
Sometimes you didn't have to look very far.
He says that he saw an angel in his orchard, and I was wondering if you had anything to do with that.
Miracles can teach us a lot about faith.
Shirley MacLaine and Terry Garstar in Waiting for the Light.
And why we didn't fly, I'll never know.
Gene Hackman and Ernest Borgnine had a stellar cast.
Hang on!
In one of the greatest disaster films ever made, The Poseidon Adventure.
We have been away from Earth for 2,000 years. Give or take a decade.
Charlton Heston is coming home to an uncertain world.
This whole thing is insane.
Return this creature to his cage.
The futuristic sci-fi classic, Planet of the Apes.
My husband said he saw people from outer space. They were from outer space.
Steve Guttenberg, Don Ameche, and Brian Dennehy had an all-star cast.
We'll never be sick. We won't get any older, and we won't ever die.
It's the Oscar-winning motion picture that captivated the world. Cocoon.
No, this is bad for America, I guess.
We've got the biggest stars in your favorite movies all summer long on the Disney Channel.
Journey to the Grand Canyon and witness a night where man and nature come together in song. When the Sunday Night Showcase brings you another original music special featuring Kenny Loggins. Disney Channel. Kenny Loggins going home.
Alakazam!
Why ask me? Why do I come into it anymore?
Hi-ho!
Disney music. It's unmistakable. Walt Disney liked his music tailor-made for tapping feet. So light and joyous, you feel like flying.